Hello students, welcome back to my channel. My name is Jagdeep and in this video series we are talking about indifference curve analysis for the advanced segment. We've been talking about the price consumption curve in a few of our previous videos. In this video, we shall take a look at the price consumption curve for inferior goods. So without wasting any time further, let's get started. Just to give you a recap, what is price effect? Price effect is something that would show you the change in consumer equilibrium due to a change in the price of one good, keeping the price of other good and the consumer's income constant. I've already discussed the meanings of income effect and substitution effect. We would need to know about these concepts before we delve into this lecture. So if you are not aware about any of these concepts, please watch the videos for these concepts first. You may find the link in the description box. When we talk about substitution effect is generally considered negative. When we say negative, what does that mean? It means that when the price of one commodity falls, since it is relatively cheaper than other commodities, a consumer would want more of that commodity. This kind of a behavior is generally considered as a negative substitution effect. Let us talk about inferior goods first. So when we talk about inferior goods, we need to remember two important things. Inferior goods are those goods which are bought when the consumer's income is low. That means a consumer is kind of compelled to buy these goods since he is not or she is not capable of affording superior commodities, generally termed as normal goods. Another thing to remember is when a consumer is buying inferior goods, a smaller proportion of his income is spent for acquiring these goods and services. Let us see what are the two things that we need to remember and understand while studying the slope of PCC curve for inferior goods. We need to remember the two effects, income effect and substitution effect. The negative income effect is not large enough to outweigh the substitution effect. Let us see what is a negative income effect first. So income effect could be considered negative when with an increase in income, a consumer reduces his quantity purchased. And generally, the income effect is negative in case of inferior goods. Okay, so we come back to the statement again. So here, negative income effect is not large enough to outweigh the substitution effect. So when we talk about which effect is more stronger than the other, we have to identify which of them is a substitution effect and which is an income effect. All right. So when the price of an inferior good falls, as far as the substitution effect is concerned, a consumer would demand or would purchase more of that particular commodity. Why is a consumer doing that? Because the commodity is now relatively cheaper than the other goods. So as a rational consumer, I would want to buy more of it. However, when we talk about the income effect, technically we are referring to the purchasing capabilities of the consumer here. Since the consumer is using a very small proportion of his income to buy these goods, not a very large proportion of his income would be released when the price of these commodities fall. That is why a consumer would want to reduce his consumption of this particular commodity and switch to a more superior commodity. So the net result of this behavior is an increase in the quantity. Let us show that on a diagram. In this particular diagram, on the y-axis, I have a superior commodity, which is full cream milk and toned milk on x-axis. Now it is to be remembered that toned milk may not always be an inferior good. We have to remember that a person is compelled to buy toned milk because he may not be capable of affording a full cream milk. All right. So if a rich person is buying toned milk because of his health concern, then that toned milk is not an inferior commodity. Let us say now if the price is falling of toned milk, we should know by now that the budget line would rotate outwards on the x-axis. So this is how it would look like. Let me name it as AB1. Now, we studied in the previous slide that the negative income effect is not large enough to outweigh the substitution effect. That means a consumer would not be willing to buy more of this particular commodity even if the real income of consumer increases, because a consumer spends a very small proportion of his income on this particular commodity. And when the price is falling, very little income is released. So income effect would not be able to outweigh the substitution effect. In this case, the consumer might increase his consumption for this particular commodity by a very little amount. Let us say the consumer is now at equilibrium on the budget line AB1, let us say at point E1 on IC curve 1. Now we see here that the consumer is able to buy a little higher quantity than before. However, he is also buying a higher quantity of commodity Y. Let me put it as Y1. So let us say he's buying Y0 initially of Y. So when the price of toned milk fell, he did increase his quantity from X0 to X1. But at the same time, he also increased his consumption of full cream milk, because now he has some spare money left with him that he can use to buy a superior commodity. So when we join these two pointers, these points, E points, we get a curve like this. This is a PCC curve, which is upward sloping. And generally, you would see it in cases of inferior goods. One thing we have to remember, that if at all the income effect is able to outweigh the substitution effect, in that case, the PCC curve would be a normal downward sloping PCC curve. Okay? If you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe to my channel. If you find my videos useful and you feel that your friends would get benefited from it, go ahead and share the videos to your friends as well. If you prefer learning in a shorter duration, follow my Instagram channel and you could find reels for most of these topics, and you could learn from there. I shall be releasing the notes for cardinal utility analysis very soon, so please stay tuned so that you get to know when the notes are released. I shall meet you again. Bye now. Take care.